California is pushing hard against President Trump on everything from border security to the economy, with far-left Governor Gavin Newsom leading the charge. But as One America's Pearson Sharp explains, a fact check proves California's latest governor was wrong about pretty much everything in his latest State of the State speech.
As Gavin Newsom heads into 2019 as California's newest governor, he's already taking aim at the White House and promising to fight President Trump's agenda at every turn. Following the president's State of the Union address on February 5th, Newsom delivered his own State of the State speech a week later. The new governor didn't waste any time attacking President Trump and his policies, hammering home his radical leftist agenda with a slew of facts, touching on everything from California's economy to illegal immigration. However, a quick fact check on Gavin's one-sided diatribe to his applauding Democrat legislators reveals California's newest leader is a little out of touch with reality. First of all, Newsom claimed the state had added over 3 million jobs since 2008. But according to the Bureau of Labor Statistics, that's not only not true, that's actually way, way off. We're not exactly sure how Gavin arrived at his numbers, but if you simply compare the number of workers in 2008 to the number of workers in 2018, you come up with just 1.8 million more. That's well over a million less than what Gavin claimed. But in the same time, California's population also grew by more than 3 million people, meaning there's over 1.2 million people in the state since 2008 that aren't working. That's not progress, Gavin. That's a massive failure. But according to Gavin himself, he actually rewards failure.
I started a failure award in my businesses because I believe in this so much. Literally a failure award. We promote and celebrate and reward the employee that screws up the most. I'm a good person to work for.
And while the governor went on to tout California's prosperity, another reality check shows there are more businesses fleeing the state than at any point in history. In 1 year alone, in 2016, nearly 2,000 companies left the state. One third of all people on welfare in the entire United States are in California. And one out of every four people in the state is below the poverty line. Which makes sense, considering six of the seven most unaffordable cities in America are in California. Keep in mind, California is basically a one-party state and is almost entirely run by liberal Democrats, meaning there's no one else to blame for the state's massive problems. In fact, in the time period Gavin Newsom references, going back to 2008, some 13,000 businesses have left the state.
The greater Phoenix region grew by 50,000 jobs last year. Meanwhile, many California companies are thinning their ranks. Chevron is moving 800 jobs from their Bay Area headquarters to Texas. Waste Connection shifted more than 100 jobs to Texas from Folsom. And other California firms are also on the move.
A form of madness, tax madness, has taken over Sacramento.
That sucked nearly $80 billion in investment capital out of California, killing some 275,000 in-state jobs at the same time. Residents are leaving too, in droves. And in 2017, 143,000 more people escaped California's suffocating taxes than arrived from other states.
More people are leaving San Francisco than any other city in the United States. That's according to Redfin.
Well, there's no question about it. The middle class is on the move. They are leaving California and the Central Coast in droves. More and more people are fleeing the Bay Area for a less taxing lifestyle.
The numbers go on and paint an incredibly bleak picture for the state's future. Finally, Gavin brought up illegal immigration, claiming it's at its lowest point since 1971 and that illegal aliens actually commit fewer crimes than native citizens. He even suggested President Trump was manufacturing the border emergency, and in fact, there is no crisis on our border.
The crisis on the border is a manufactured crisis. And we are not interested in participating in this political theater. I think it's nothing more than political theater.
So let's take a look at those claims, because as far as the evidence goes, Gavin's got his facts completely backwards. First of all, he's wrong about the border crossings. Last year, the Border Patrol arrested some 400,000 people trying to cross the southern border. That's a 31% jump up just from 2017. In fact, from October of 2018 to January of this year, crossings have doubled from the same period last year, from 109,000 to 201,000. At that rate, apprehensions at the border will be up to 600,000 by this October, on track for the highest number of crossings in over a decade. In San Diego alone, Border Patrol arrests are up over 600% from last year. That's huge. Next, and this one is one of the biggest, Gavin's claim about peaceful, hardworking illegals is totally untrue. A report by the Government Accountability Office looked at the criminal histories of more than 55,000 aliens who entered the country illegally. The results were shocking. Those 55,000 illegal aliens had been arrested 459,000 times, meaning each illegal was arrested an average of 8 times. And they were responsible for 700,000 criminal offenses, from robbery to violent assault to rape and child molestation. In just the last 2 years, 30,000 aliens were arrested for sex crimes, including rape and child abuse. And over 100,000 illegal aliens are in custody for committing violent assaults against American citizens. Since 2016, 4,000 Americans would still be alive if Washington and Sacramento had worked harder to protect our borders. And while illegals are just 7.5% of the U.S. population, data from the U.S. Sentencing Commission showed that almost half of all federal convictions are illegal aliens. Half. And these aren't minor drug crimes. This isn't someone being arrested for having a bag of weed. This is assault, auto theft, rape, and murder. Illegals commit over 75% of all drug-related offenses and 37% of all the murders in the entire country. So how is it possible Gavin Newsom believes they're less violent than Native American citizens? Gavin's right about one thing, though. This isn't a crisis anymore. It's gone way beyond that. Illegal immigration costs the U.S. hundreds of billions of dollars annually, puts national security at risk, and claims the lives of American citizens every year. That includes Americans like Drew Rosenberg, Ronald Da Silva, Sarah Root, Tessa Tranchin, Grant Runnebeck, Shayla Estes, and countless others, all of whom would still be alive today if not for illegal aliens. Worse, the people you elected are allowing and encouraging these illegals to roam free. And here in California, we're spending more than $30 billion a year, over 17% of the entire state budget, supporting illegal aliens. And that's for life. The U.S. Census just revealed nearly 70% of non-citizens in America are on welfare. And once they're on it, they end up never working. It's not just or fair for someone to sneak into America illegally and then somehow be given the same rights and privileges to determine the future of our country. But that's exactly what people like Gavin Newsom are fighting for.
Together, let us build a house stronger than the coming storms, yet open to the world. A house that provides shelter to all who need it and sanctuary to all who seek it.
It's fine for him to stand up and make grand speeches commending illegals and declaring there's no such thing as a border emergency. But for the parents of children who were killed by illegals, and for the rest of us who must support them their entire lives, reality is much different. The toll they take on America and the crimes they commit never would have happened if these aliens hadn't been able to enter the country in the first place. Our country was built by Americans, for Americans. And until our sovereign borders are protected, that liberty and our safety will always be at risk. For One America News, I'm Pearson Sharp.